Okay, guys. So the day comes to an end. We are here at Panipat, and thanks to my brother Sagar, right over there. He wanted me to stay back. He's been in touch over the years. A very good biker brother. And the plan was to go up to Ambala, but now we're tired. I have to sit and edit two more videos. So I think this is the right choice. And we have a good location, and hoping that the accommodation is good and the net speed is good, such that I can upload the videos on time. So we have an open terrace dinner specially arranged by Sagar, biker pro. Wow, looking so awesome, so super awesome actually. This is beautiful, really really special. Thank you, Sagar. Thank you so much. So sipping on virgin mojito, munching on malai paneer, mouth watering malai paneer. Virgin boy Kiran enjoying the meal and amazing music. Brown Munde. Hi guys, welcome to day 4 of Hyderabad to Ladakh ride. Now we are in close to Agra now, and we're going to bypass Delhi. Yes, the plan was to meet Jaspaji and spend some time, but now the mind is all focused on Ladakh. The weather is good over there, so better utilize this time to access Ladakh as soon as possible, finish it off, enjoy it to the fullest. And on the way back, we're going to celebrate in grand style. Because Delhi is like my second home, I keep saying that my brother's home is there, so I can go anytime, have fun. I'm going to stay there for more than just a day, so that is the reason why I'm just trying to bypass that for now. Paji ko bol diya, Paji is available over phone to help me out, because this is the first time going through Ladakh. And other biker brothers are also there. We have Azhar Bhaijan, who is with us since yesterday, who's helping us out and trying to support us to his max capability. And now the plan is to go towards Panipat. The western periphery highway is a new one, which helps us, you know, bypass Delhi and all the traffic and the commotion that it has. In fact, especially like the farmers protest that's happening, that might slow you down in a huge way if you go that route. To avoid that, the best way is to go to Panipat via the western periphery road, which has been Western Periphery Highway Expressway, which has been newly inaugurated and launched. So I would suggest you try that as well if you're coming towards Ladakh. And Panipat jaake uske baad decide karenge ki agar aage ja sake to jayenge, or towards Ludhiana and Ambala. And let's see how the rest of the day unfolds. Let's hit the road. I am super excited. Ladakh, here we come. Hello there guys, I'm back, and we have finally reached Panipat, and the hotel is Orlov Hotel, and we started from Agra, close to Agra, you guys know that. And the plan actually was to go to Delhi to meet Paji, and then spend a day there or take some rest, and then start towards Srinagar and start towards Pathankot. But what happened was, because I was more focused with the form and the kind of, you know, rush that we have to get to Ladakh as soon as possible and experience the glorious splendor of the mighty Ladakh. And that's the reason why I spoke to Paji and I said I'll be, you know, spending quality time and, you know, taking rest on the way back and celebrate the, you know, moment that we have you know, conquered or kind of experienced Ladakh. So the plan was that. So now we headed, we bypassed Delhi. Now how did we do that? There's something called the Western Periphery Expressway that has been recently unveiled or kind of opened up. So this allows you to come directly to Panipat, and from here you can either go to Ambala. So Paji had given me the target of halting at Ambala because the hotels are good, the place is good, full of buzz and activity. And he said you can take rest for a day or two there and then head towards Srinagar or Pathankot. So what we did, as soon as we're coming towards Panipat, a biker brother who has been in touch and supporting my vision, he has been touch on Instagram. And Sagar is his name, and you might have seen in the intro part and everything, and how he welcomed us and showed us the hotel and everything. So he has arranged for the accommodation, and he was courteous enough to invite us over and have us over. And he was requesting, bhai, ho sake to ek din aap yahan pe ruk jaiye, next day aap nikal jana towards Pathankot or towards Srinagar. So because of his insistence, we stayed here, and it was already evening by the time we were at Panipat. And Panipat is the battle city, is the city of textiles, is the city of weavers, is what they say. Largest handloom industry, one of the best in the world. Everyone looks up to Panipat. This is what it is famous for, and also the massive or famous battles. So they call it the battle city. But it's the roads are amazing, the scenery is beautiful, and the people are amazing as well. This particular hotel is absolutely outstanding in terms of luxury, accommodation, food, and the ambience is next level. So thanks to Sagar for directing us directly to the right hotel, such that we could get some much needed rest. We've been riding continuously for 4 days, so close to 1800 kilometers covered so far. And yes, so now the plan is to head towards Pathankot, and we're going to have some breakfast. And you guys kept requesting me, Dinobhai, why don't you talk a little bit about the motorcycle, why you chose Apache RR310. Now you guys know that even for my ride to Kanyakumari, RR310 was my chosen weapon of choice. And the reason was the kind of stability it has on offer. It's a fared bike, so it offers very good wind protection. And secondly, the kind of riding posture it has on offer, it is not too forward biased, or not kind of a typical super sport like an RC390 or an RC200, where it is far more aggressive. This one is more like the Ninja 300 or my R3. It is nice and upright, and the wind protection is really, really effective. Aerodynamics are good. It doesn't heat up way too much. The engine heat management is really good. And basically, the suspension, the handling, and the stability is absolutely on point. So even with the luggage on board, with tackling different terrains, the bike has behaved very stable, and it has behaved very positively through different terrains all the way up to nearly 1800 kilometers. And I'm sure we'll be able to enjoy all the glorious splendor of Ladakh as well on the RR310. So this is where we stand. Currently, we are at Panipat Orlov Hotel, the terrace portion where we actually dined for the dinner. It's a fine dining experience, one of the best that I've experienced in recent times. And special thanks to my biker bro Sagar for being so caring and so loving towards us and taking care of everything despite being super busy himself. He took time out for us. So that talks about the biking brotherhood and the respect we have for each other. So a lot of more brothers will be meeting. We met Azhar bhai at Agra, then Sagar here at Panipat. Maybe more biker bros will be meeting through the course of this journey. Already a hippie on super bikes, mana Yashwantane Abbai akada, he is waiting for me here. They have already they are heading towards Ladakh, is what I heard. I just had a word with him, so hopefully we'll be meeting him as well. So all this is going to unfold in the coming series, so stay tuned for that. I'll catch you guys in the next vlog. So until then, God bless, ride safe, and take care of yourself.